I have an old Android tablet. It's Android 5, so obviously I can no longer download from the store. So make sure you plug the tablet, just put the connector into it, and go on your desktop or a laptop, whatever you have. And you want to know the program name. My program that I want to download, it's called Calc Tape. So I'm really just browsing on Google, right? It's just Windows 10 computer. And you look for the program name and then type in APK. Make a pause and typing APK. APK, it's the type of files that get installed, the program names if you want. So look for a program. Hopefully it's there. It's not always going to be the case. You may find it or not. I do recommend the APK Pure site. I did not have problem with viruses and stuff from this site, but you never know. So always be careful what you download, what you click also. So I did search on Google, gives me this result here. I'm going to click, and this is the page. I suggest you also scroll down someplace, depends on the site, you will find the minimum Android version that you need to have to download these older programs. Usually it's going to be Android 5. So also make sure you click the right download button. You know, these sites have a tricky or catchy virus download buttons, not the real ones. They have fake sometimes buttons. So careful with the site that you use. I'm going to download the file. It looks like this. Now let me show you already the file in the folder. So here it goes. So this is the file that I did download. And what I want to point is that sometimes the name of the file, it's so long that your tablet or your phone, Android, it's have going to have trouble installing such a long name. So right click, we are still on the desktop, sorry, not properties, but rename. Let's rename this thing. And I'm going just to reduce the name, make it much, much shorter. Leave it maybe one line long or so, just to be sure. You can rename it on the tablet afterwards. It doesn't have to be the correct name, just the APK. Make sure you don't change that APK. So right now, this is the tablet here. I'm going to throw it. So let me show you. Where is it? Where is it? It's Galaxy tablet, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to throw it into the download folder, but it's not necessarily, you can use any other folder. Just make sure you know where you put it. So let's just drag it. I'm on the desktop computer, right? So it's this is Windows, what I'm doing here. Actually, I already had it there, but is it there? Okay, there you have it. Calc tape. So right now it's on the tablet. A few things I'm going to suggest. First, what you need to do is go on, I'm in the settings, right? So go in the Let's go lock screen and security, and you need to check this one here. So it's lock screen security. Allow installation of apps from other source, the Play Store. Make sure you put it, whoops, typed it wrongly. Make sure this is at green, on, activated. It's going to look deactivate. The other thing, you see my tablet here has a night mode program or so. You will see. Let's just try to install first. You'll see what happens when the night mode is on. So this is the file. And funny enough, I don't have the download part here. So what I'm going to do is just stop here, and it's going to show the download folder. So if you tap for a new tab here, you will see all the folder. So this is the Calc tape. I'm just tapping on it. And now you see the install button here. However, because I have a night screen, I cannot type on install. If you don't have a night screen, it's going to work without problems. So for it's just I'm giving you an extra tip. Let's go for the settings. Let's go for the apps, and I just need to turn my night screen program. It's called like this night screen. Let's just force stop it. Okay, so right now night screen, even if it's not dim, and it's just a glitch, right? Another glitch. So let's just go back to Calc tape stuff, and it's going to install it. It's going to take a few moments. Again, you may or may not find the program that you're looking for. You make sure at least having Android 5, I think. Some programs will require Android 6, but this way you can install pretty much everything that's on internet. It's just a database, internet basically. App installed, open, and whatever. Okay, so that's my app that I got as a simple file from internet using Google, Windows, and all other things.